myself, Sandesh Suresh Kirte, HOD Computer Technology Department, Brahmadev Dada Male Polytechnic, Solapur. Today, I am going to deliver the lecture on the subject operating system, and the point is a types of an operating system. In a previous session, already we have covered the concept of an operating system, the components of an operating system, as well as the views of an operating system. So basically, the operating system performs a basic task, like it manages memory, I/O devices, other peripheral resources, file system, and it becomes the interface in between the user and the computer system. It also provides the efficient environment to execute the user his program efficiently and easily. So let's start the concept, the types of an operating system. In a types of an operating system, there are many types are included in the operating system, but we have covered that much only which is included in our syllabus contents. In our syllabus, batch operating system, multi-programming operating system, time share operating system, multi-processor operating system, distributed operating system, real-time operating system, and then mobile operating system, also we call as a Android operating system. Among these, the first two, the batch operating system and multi-program operating system, are the non-interactive operating systems, and after this, the time share and multiprocessor operating systems are the interactive operating systems, and remaining also are come under the interactive operating systems. So in today's session, we have covered only the batch OS, the multi-programming operating system, the time sharing operating system, and the multiprocessor operating system. So let's start the batch operating system. This diagram describes the batch operating system. Basically, the batch operating system is an oldest type of an operating system, where only the large programs or large data will be accessed. It is a non-interactive system, so here the user can't directly interact with the operating system as well as the program. Here, instead of interacting directly with the operating system and the programs, the user goes offline and prepare the jobs. After that, the user will submit their jobs at a computer operator. It is the component which sort that jobs as per the similar requirement or the similar nature. Further, the computer operator forms the batches. So this operating system is called as a batch operating system. Further, the batches are sent towards the computer system for a further execution. Whenever the user wants to constitute a job, that time the batch operating system provides a language, that is a JCL, which is called as a job control language, which has a self instruction set. By using that instruction set, the user can create or prepare their jobs. Always the job begin instruction start the job, and the job instruction it end the job. Whenever the batch OS encounter a job begin statement, then it go for the execution of that specific job, and it will understand the job will be commencing. And after one by one statements executing, it will accomplishes that job, and whenever it encounters the job end statement, that time it will be understand that the job will be finishes, and it switches to the next job. In this way, the batch operating system performs the execution in a serial fashion, or we can say it is in a sequential fashion. Here, the batch operating system is a non-interactive system, and also it performs a execution in a sequential manner, so the next processes or the next job will remains in a unwanted wait status. It means here the execution time will be increased as well as the throughput will be decreased. So to overcome the increase in waiting time and decrease in throughput, we will see the another types of operating system, that is a multi-programming operating system. For going through the multi-programming operating system, firstly we go through the serial execution. Here the process P1 and the process P2 wants to execute. In this, the P1 perform the CPU operation, the P1 performs the IO operation, same like that the P2 also perform the CPU and the IO operations. Whenever a specific process or a P1 process going for the IO operation, that time it utilizes the IO devices, and in that specific time of slot the CPU will reach at a idle state. It means it is a not working condition. But the CPU can't allocate to the another process because it is a sequential execution. Whenever accomplish a previous task or current task, the CPU will not allocate to the next process. Due to this feature, here the P2 process will waiting unnecessarily. So to overcome this, the multi-programming operating system, where the name itself suggests that the multi means number of or many programs can be executed at a time, the multi-programming operating system expect the number of jobs or number of programs resides at a time or a same time in a main memory. But the main memory is a too small to accommodate all that programs at a same time. So in this case, the main memory needs a assist. So a multi-program operating system utilizes the second storage or a disk to assist the main memory, and it makes a space. That space is called a job pool. Initially, all the programs and the data of the user jobs are stored on a job pool, and as per the requirement of execution, it will be retrieved in a main memory. But there are number of programs are stored in a job pool, so they all want to reside in a main memory, but it is not possible. So the operating system will go to allocate the space, or will go to allocation of space in a memory for different jobs. This term is called as a job scheduling. Further, the operating system loads the jobs from the job pool to the main memory, and it performs the execution concurrently. Concurrently means whenever the operating system go for the execution of specific job, and if specific that process wants to perform the IO operation, or it is in a wait state, that time the OS leave that process and switches to another process for the execution. If the next process also repeat the same things, then the multi-program operating system switches to another process, and so on. As the same fashion, it will allocate the CPU to next process. In this diagram, we show the nature of the multi-programming operating system. Here, the process P1 first will go for the execution. It allocates the CPU time. After that, it is in a wait state. It means here it will require some data, or it will perform some IO operations here. So automatically the control or program control is transferred to the process P2, and the process P2 will utilize the CPU time. And after that, it will go in a wait state and performing the IO operations and another jobs. So the next process, that is a P3, will assign the processor. In this way, instead of waiting the whole process completion or accomplishing the whole process, the process P2 will allocate directly the CPU after the waiting state of the process P1. So here the waiting time must be minimized. In this way, here we can clearly see that in a multiple operating system, firstly P1 utilize CPU, then P2 utilize CPU, and P3 utilize CPU, and partly complete the job. After that, the rest state is there, and after that, the P1, P2, P3 simultaneously get the CPU, and all they are accomplishes their task. In this way, the multiprogram operating system minimizes the waiting and the increase the throughput. The throughput means it is the term where we can consider the number of programs executing in a specific time period. So it is a maximized in a multi-programming operating system. The batch operating system and the multi-programming operating system both are the non-interactive system. So here user submit their job and wait till accomplishes that, and after the accomplishes, the OS will give its output in the form of the result. So the interaction with the operating system or the program, it is not possible in the batch operating system and a multi-programming operating system. As well as the batch operating system perform the job in a sequential manner, here the multi-programming operating system perform the job a concurrent or a parallel fashion and increase the utilization of CPU as well as the all the resources. But the limitation of the multi-program operating system is that it is also a non-interactive. So to overcome this limitation will arise the next types of an operating system, that is a time share operating system. Time sharing operating system. In the time sharing operating system, the number of terminals or number of CPUs are there which shares a common memory and a common CPU. Or there are the number of users which shares a common memory and a common CPU for executing their jobs. They submit their jobs. They submit their jobs. Here a timeshare supervisor which allocates the CPU time for the specific user. Here the CPU or the operating system allocates a small time period to each user, so it can move or it can be switched among all the users very fastly or very rapidly. So all the users are performing their job, and it feels like that the entire system is dedicated to him or her only. But there are number of computers or users are connected through the network. In the time sharing system, the resources are also shared effectively. Then the time sharing system utilizes a common memory as well as this common CPU. Now, totally inverse of time sharing system, there is a multi-process operating system. Here, the number of users are shared a common memory and the CPU. Totally inverse here, the number of processors are shared a common computer system. Here, the processor have its private memory, register and CPU also, but they are connected through the common IO devices, bus and memory. So number of processors are execute their request on a common computer system. In this way, the sharing and non-sharing of a memory divides the multiprocessor system into two parts. The two parts are nothing but the symmetric multiprocessing system, and the next one is the asymmetric multiprocessing system. The symmetric multiprocessor system is a general multiprocessor system where number of processors shares common I/O, common memory, and the common buses and perform their tasks as per the allocation of the CPU. Here, in a multiprocessor system, if one of the processors which are connected through the common system are failed, that time it doesn't affect on the whole system. Instead of the effect on the whole system, the remaining processors or the remaining systems are take charge of that specific processor or specific system and perform their task also. It accomplishes the whole task but affects on the speed or performance of the system because the task is overridden on the another systems. So in this way, the multiprocessor system gradually decreases their speed, or we can say decreases the throughput of the operating system. Now we go for the types of and multiprocessor operating systems. The symmetric type indicates that here all the processors share the common memory, but each and every processor acts as a peer, or we can say independent computer. It has one private memory, it has one CPU, so all the processors are able to perform all the tasks. Here no one can be categorized as slave or no one can be categorized as a master. So no any computer from their network are instructed to another computer. So we can say that in a symmetric multiprocessor system, no master-slave relationship is present, all are at the same level. Inversely, a symmetric multiprocessing system, here all the computers are not shared a common memory. They are acts as a master-slave. It means among those, the one is act as a master, it will perform all the activities of the asymmetric multiprocessor system. It allocates, then it executes, or it allocates and it deallocates the tasks to the all the systems. In this way, in asymmetric multiprocessor system, the master-slave relationship is exist. So in today's session, we have covered the type under the types of operating system: batch operating system, multi-programming operating system, time sharing operating system, multi-processor operating system, distributed operating system, real-time operating system, and the mobile OS. Among those, only about 4 are covered. In a next session, remaining are we will cover. So we want to stop here. Thank you.